and do our own thing. God wants to do something great in us. Christians, let me share with you. To everybody on Facebook, God bless you. Good to see you. Good to hear from you. All those messages sent me. I appreciate it. Amen. But I want to know that in your struggle, while you are sitting on your bed with your coffee in your hand or with your whiskey in your hand or whatever you got in your hand, it doesn't even matter. But let me tell you, your struggles, amen, could be at the hands of God. And I don't care how many prayers you have prayed. Let me tell you this, my brother and my sister, it's at the will of God, amen. Maybe God is trying to get you somewhere. Maybe you prayed a prayer back in the day and God, you didn't forget about the prayer, but God never forgot. He heard your prayer, and the way that he answered prayer is that he moves things and move you to get to your answer. Lord have mercy. He just don't work like man. You just can't come up to him and ask, Lord, can I have this? And then he's a, he give it out to you like that. Not always. God don't do it like that. When you got saved, let me tell you something. When you got saved and really gave your heart over to God, you belong to him. You no longer belong to yourself. Preach, Reverend Smith. And that's why he said, in everything that you got, learn to give me thanks. Amen. Because if you're not where you are or where you think you ought to be, maybe God has not gotten you there yet. There are sometimes he'll pause on you. Yes, he will. Y'all remember the children of Israel? Amen. Do you know that the children of Israel went through a struggle for 40 years? They didn't have to go through the, oh Lord have mercy. They didn't have to go through the wilderness of struggle. They didn't have to. But because of their disobedience, God allowed them to walk around in the wilderness of struggle. For 40 years. 40 years. 4 is the world number. 40 is the number of testing. You'll see 40 throughout the Old Testament scripture, but you have to think about that.